I mean, what's complement?
In 2's complement, you ignore this number. So what's your result? Your final result is 0011001010111010. That is the number. And since you are getting end around carry, you have the final answer, which is a negative number.
That means this number is greater than this particular number. You are getting a negative number.
And you have to convert it back into hexadecimal number. Again, group them. I think I have committed mistake somewhere. So I have grouped the number, and now I am writing this number as 3, this number as 2, this number is 1101, so it is D, and this is 1110, it is E. So my answer to this question is, note this carries 4 marks. Part B of the question is, draw pin diagram of 8085 and sight function of each pin. It's a descriptive question. This 8085 is IC with 80 pins. And all those pin configuration, as we are seeing in our slide in our first or second lecture, you have to draw that and you have to explain each pin function, what does it do. C part of the question is, what are the purpose of the following pins in 8085 microprocessor? And those are, functions of following pins in a microprocessor, and those pins are ALE. Second is ready, READY. Third is hold, and fourth is hold acknowledge. These are the pins which have been specified. These are the pins which are present in 8085, and we are asked to explain what are the functions of these pins very specifically. What is the purpose? What does this ALE stand for? It stands for address latch enable. It is ALE. It stands for address latch enable. And what is the function of it? Microprocessor sends the address onto address bus. That address is taken to a particular memory location or input or output device. And there you have one particular latch. In that latch, that address has to go and stay. Why? Because after sending that address, microprocessor may like to send that particular data. Let us say, microprocessor wants to write a particular data in a memory location having address X. How will microprocessor function? Microprocessor will put out that address X onto address bus. Then that X is expected to go to a memory location and get it latched there. It has to stay because subsequently microprocessor is needing to send that data X to be written in that memory. And address and data bus is multiplexed. If it sends address and suddenly if it sends that particular data, then memory may not understand what exactly is to be done. So before memory, just touching to memory, there is one particular latch, and in that latch address has to go and stay, so that next time when the data X comes in, memory would know that this is the address where data X is to be stored. And for that latching purposes, microprocessor needs to send that signal that I am sending this address, please latch it in your latch register. Please remember that, because I am missing this particular address now from the address bus and sending the data next. So sequence would be as below. For writing a data D at a memory location X, microprocessor will perform following activities. 1. Put address X onto address bus. ALE is enabled. Pin ALE is now connected via some control bus to that latch. The moment ALE goes high, latch would know that content from the address bus are to be taken in and latched. So it will take that address and latch. Latch means after that ALE goes low, it will close the door and no content from address or data bus will come to that ALE. ALE is there, that latch register is there, it is connected with address bus and it is also connected by a control bus in which there is one pin ALE connected from a microprocessor. So address X has come out. It is available on the address bus. ALE goes high. Till the time ALE is high, latch will keep its door open so that content from address bus will come in. And the moment ALE goes low, it will capture it and close the door. So that now address is residing in that register, in that latch register. Afterwards, when data X is sent on the address bus or data bus, it will not come in that latch. It will come to some different register. Read or write signal will open up that particular register and send it to the microprocessor, memory, so that memory knows which is the address, which is the data, at what address, what data is to be written, and action will be performed. So ALE pin stands for address latch enable, and wherever that address latch is available, it will be enabled by this particular pin, provided the line is connected to that particular latch on that microprocessor. Ready is another pin from microprocessor. Once one particular instruction execution is over, ready pin will go low. And just before starting of the next instruction execution, the ready pin will go high. The moment ready pin goes high, all system will start getting the command from microprocessor. It is an indication by microprocessor that now I am starting the operation. So all pins, all registers, all buses will be attentive to what microprocessor has to say. So ready pin is that particular part. Hold and hold acknowledge. These are certain aspects which need to be discussed very carefully. It goes as follows. Microprocessor is performing some action. That is some instruction it is executing. It is a machine cycle M1. What is microprocessor is executing? Under that M1, there is one T state, T1. T T1 is being executed, T2 is being executed, T3 and T4 are being executed. So once T1, T2, T3, T4 are executed, first machine cycle execution is over. Next machine cycle is M2. That M2 is to be executed. Under that M2, T1, T2, T3 will be 3 T states available, and those 3 T states will be executed. In between these two, for some reason, if microprocessor wants to add delay, it will do so by generating this signal called hold. The moment it holds, the moment it generates a signal hold, machine cycle 2 will not be entered into. And this hold is required all the time. As an example, when microprocessor gets interrupt, what would microprocessor do? It will complete that M1, machine cycle 1, and then stop functioning for M2, M3 by generating hold. The moment it generates hold, all those devices which were working with M1 will hold, and they will generate that hold acknowledge, and that hold acknowledge will be. So hold and hold acknowledge, these are the pins through which microprocessor can ask some system to hold and acknowledge that particular hold, or microprocessor can get a signal as a hold and acknowledge that particular hold depending upon the system design, the way we do. So these are the functions of these four pins. So question 2 has 3 parts, A, B, C. A was the 2's complement subtraction carrying 4 marks. B was draw pin diagram of 8085 and sight function of each pin. It carried 8 marks. And the C, in which these 4 are to be explained properly, that carries 4 marks. Question 3 is there, and question 3 is, identify the addressing mode of the following instruction. Addressing mode is to be identified for following instructions. 1, move A, M. 2 is move immediate C, 0A. 3, LDA, ADDR, address. And 4th instruction is move A, B. These are the 4 instructions, and we have to identify what is the addressing mode in each one of them. Have a look at the first one. You are specifying movement of data from a memory location addressed by HL pair as M to the accumulator A. You expect content from M to move to A, and this M is addressed by register pair HL. So what does that mean? It means it is a register addressing mode. It is a register addressing mode because it is register HL pair which is addressing that particular memory. This is MVIC 0A. Again, there is appearance of I. I means immediate. Immediately available data, hexadecimal data 0A, is to be moved to register C. So it is an immediate address. The data is being addressed immediately, so it is an immediate address. Here it is load address. Load address. Now this address is a hexadecimal number, 2 bytes number, and it is to be loaded to a particular place. It is a direct address once again because address is available immediately. And move A, B. The data from register B is moved to A, so it is again a register address. So these are the addressing modes we have been discussing about different instructions. And if you go through instruction set given to you in the textbook, you'll find that modes of addressing are also described for each one of them. Part B of the second next question asks you, two RAMs. There are two RAMs, TWO, two RAMs of 4K each are to be interfaced with 8085. Give in detail setup for interfacing decoding circuit and address map. This is very good question, and always it is expected that this kind of circuit design should be well known to us. Let us see how do we do that. How much memory we have? 4 kilo plus 4 kilo, because there are two chips. So I'll draw a circuit first. This is 2K RAM. This is another 2K RAM. And they are connected to address bus like this. This is my address data bus. And I am asked to design chip select for this, chip select for this. When should I select this circuit and when should I select this particular chip? There are two different chips. So when should I select chip number one and when should I select chip number two is to be designed, defined. This definition will come with the help of CS. Read-write operation onto this RAM will be defined by RD and WR signals. And RD and WR signals are directly coming straight away from microprocessor, so I don't have to bother about it. The read operation will be taken care by RD bar line. Write operation will be taken care by WR line by a microprocessor, which are directly available to this RAM as well. What I need to do is, I need to find out of 16 address lines, which line should I select for enabling this particular chipset, CS1 or CS2. And that map I have to generate. So let me first generate the map over here. This is for chip 1 and this is for chip 2. Right? Now, I have 4 kilo each. So, again, 2 to power n should be equal to or greater than 4. That is the formula I have to use. And this is 4 kilo. So, 1 kilo requires 10 address lines. 2 kilo will require 11 address lines and 4 kilo will require how much? 14 such lines. So out of 16 lines, 14 lines will define what location in this particular RAM I am going to. I have 16 lines. Out of it, 14 lines I will be requiring for addressing location inside this particular chip. How many lines I am still left over with? 2. And these 2 lines are good enough for me to select one of the 2 RAMs.